very important, Oswald dilution law. Oswald dilution law, its uses and limitations. So Oswald dilution law are applicable to the for weak electrolytes. There exists a dynamic equilibrium between the ions and dissociated molecules. For example, AB is the electrolyte and it is divided like to the cation of A plus, anion of B minus. These both are equilibrium to the electrolyte. On applying the law of mass action to the above equilibrium, so we can be write that one K equal to A plus into B minus by AB. A plus into B minus. A plus into B minus by AB. Here K equal to ionization constant or dissociation constant. If 1 ml of this weak electrolyte AB is taken in V liters of solution, V volume of solution, then let's the degree of dissociation is alpha. AB equilibrium A plus plus B minus from above reaction. Here AB equilibrium A plus plus B minus. At initial place, AB 1 mole, cation and anions are 0. At equilibrium place, 1 minus alpha means from the 1 mole, cations obtained alpha, from the 1 moles, anions obtained alpha. Okay. Next, concentration at equilibrium. 1 minus alpha by V. So here, 1 mole of weak electrolyte AB is taken in V volume liters of solution. That's why 1 minus alpha by V. Same alpha by V. Alpha by V. From equation number 1, K equal to A plus into B minus by AB. This is the equation number 1. I written here same. K equal to A. What is A? A alpha by V. I written here alpha by V into B minus. What is there here? B minus alpha by V. Alpha by V. By. Here is a by there now. By. AB. What is AB here? AB 1 minus alpha. 1 minus alpha by V. AB is here 1 minus alpha by V. I written here 1 minus alpha by V. Alpha into alpha, alpha square. Here alpha square. V into V, V square. As it is same, 1 minus alpha by V. K equal to alpha square by V square into V by 1 minus alpha. This denominator go to the numerator. That's why alpha square by V square. Simple, this V values go to the up. Right. Next here, V and here V square. So, one V is cancelled by the this V. Okay. Remain K equal to alpha square by 1 minus alpha into V. This is the equation number 1. This equation is the, this is the formula of Oswald dilution law. So therefore 1 by V equal to C. Here think about here 1 by V. So that is equal to the C. Substitute in that place of 1 by V. K equal to C. In this place 1 by V we substitute, C alpha square by 1 minus alpha. So this is the second formula of the Ostwald dilution. Degree of dissociation alpha is very small in weak electrolytes. We are discussing about for weak electrolyte Ostwald dilution law. So degree of dissociation alpha is very small in weak electrolyte. So this is the Ostwald dilution law formula, K equal to C alpha square by 1 minus alpha. So here 1 minus alpha similar to the 1 because of it is very less dissociation in weak electrolyte, so that 1 minus alpha equal to the 1. So in this place K equal to C alpha square, this 1 minus alpha because of it is 1 value, K equal to C alpha square. C is come to the out of the equal to, then alpha square equal to K by C. Here alpha square equal to K by C is there, we can be write like this, alpha equal to at the root of K by C. Here K is the constant value, so that value is the 1. Alpha is proportional to 1 by at the root of C. So we know that 1 by C equal to V. So alpha directly proportional to at the root of V. In this place of 1 by C, we can write alpha directly proportional to at the root of V. Alpha equal to at the root of KV. In this, alpha equal to at the root of KV. So here remove proportional, we take one constant, alpha equal to at the root of KV. It can be used for calculate the degree of dissociation of weak electrolytes, not strong electrolytes. So the formulas are two there. Formula 1, alpha equal to at the root of K by C. The second formula is the alpha equal to at the root of K into. When you use formula 1 or formula 2, we can be calculate the degree of dissociation of a weak electrolyte and its limitations. So it can be applicable to be weak electrolytes, for example acetic acid, ammonium hydroxide, it not to be strong electrolytes. Okay, thank you.